Even though I have a newer MacBook Pro 2017 which I work with all the time, I'm still keeping my old MacBook Pro 2011 around for certain reasons. However, the touchpad went bad and became almost unusable. I bought a replacement on Amazon and I'll leave the link in the description below. It's been working great for about a month now. The difficulty level is pretty low and I think anyone should be able to do it so far you can handle a screwdriver well and you're careful with things like this. The first thing you want to do is flip the MacBook Pro over and remove the stand screws holding the bottom panel in place. With the screws out of the way, you should be able to easily remove the cover. Now that you're staring at the internals, you're probably wondering what to do next. The touchpad you intend to replace is right under the battery, so you want to remove the two screws holding the battery down. There is one on the left side of the battery here. You should use a pry tool to lift the battery cable and pop it out of this socket. I'm using a screwdriver because my pry tool is damaged. Remove the second screw on the right holding the battery down. You should be able to pull the battery out by pulling this tab. Now that the faulty touchpad is revealed, it's time to take it out. Since I'm replacing the touchpad together with the flex cable, I'm disconnecting it straight from the logic board here. Just pop it out from this socket. Now you need to remove these Phillips head screws. There are four to the left and another four to the right. You're not removing every single one of them, just the two on each side as shown in this video. With those out of the way, you can slide a cable out from this hole and completely detach the touchpad. Here is a replacement I got from Amazon and like I said, it's been working great with no issues. It might even be as good as the original one. Slide the cable in and position the touchpad properly. Replace the four screws you removed here. Clip the cable back in place. Position the battery, put back the two screws you removed and reattach the cable to the board. Complete the reassemble and you're good to go. This tutorial should also work for MacBook Pro 2010 since it has the same build as the MacBook Pro 2011. If this video works for you, do hit the like button and consider subscribing. Hopefully, I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe.